So coming to politics, I have seen you campaigning with Rahul Gandhi in 2004 in Amethi when he contested for the first time. I was there to report that election. So how do you see the experience you gained through all these elections and also with the association with the Gandhi family?
So I've been campaigning since 1999, and it was a very difficult election because the candidate from the BJP side was Sanjay Singh, who had lots of, he was like the Raja of the area in Amethi. So he had a lot of cars and vehicles that would come and try to intimidate some of our workers, and there would be, almost like booth capturing or things like that. So we would have to work very hard to make our workers believe and have them trust in us that we are there with you, stand strong, don't let anything go wrong. It should be a fair, free and fair election. So, the voting should be correct and so on. So obviously we worked very hard. We also put posters up at night. We gave all the, whatever requirements of documents to all our workers, and we gave them an inspirational speech, talked to them. So that was 1999, then 2004, which again was a very difficult election. We worked really hard with Rahul, Priyanka and a few other people, and I worked for many months there. And, we came back with the biggest majority in India for Mrs. Gandhi. And, we could be, that nobody could stop her from being Prime Minister, So it was a lot of hard work, and it had a very good result.
Yeah. You contributed your part for that.
I did. I always do. I always do in every way possible. I always do. Right. Being part of the Gandhi family is like, with great power comes great responsibility. So I've been always responsible in my ways of, as an individual in this country, because of to keep the respect of my family as well.
But if I can ask you, often rumors come out that your relationship with the family or Sonia ji is not good and all. So why such rumors always come out?
Because this is the only family that is always speaking for the people of India, who's always fighting for the people of India in parliament, outside the parliament. So when to try and show the family in a bad light, or try and influence people in a negative way about the family, they will always bring up something about me or something related to Rahul, and try and do that very clearly. I think they won't do that with Priyanka and Mrs. Gandhi, because for women, people will be very upset if you hear negative things. For men, they feel that they can say it and get away with it. But we are very strong people, and I've learned a lot from the Gandhi family. They lost Mrs. Indira Gandhi in an assassination. Also, Mr. Rajiv Gandhi was assassinated. So they've lost their loved ones for the nation, and they gave their loved ones to the nation. So obviously, I've learned a lot from them. I've learned how to be strong, how to relate to everything, and how to handle everything, the negative forces around.
But this time there's a confusion regarding Amethi and Rae Bareli. So what is the reason for that confusion?
The reason is simple, that when I worked in 99 and many years from there to now, for the people in Amethi, Rae Bareli, people feel that there was a mistake that they put Smriti Irani and made her win, and they feel that they want to overcome that mistake, that they want somebody from the Gandhi family to partake in politics. Now, they see me for the last many years work very hard with my charitable organizations, with my spiritual tours, and reaching out for everybody every alternate day, every day practically, to help people, to give them whatever I can do. People come to my outside my office, people come to meet me outside my residence, and whatever I can do for them, they see I always do. For every it doesn't have to be an event, it doesn't have to be a festival, I do it every day.
So you are ready to contest in Amethi?
So people see that I should be in politics. People see that they have BJP and other parties have used my name since 2011 in a very negative way to try and create some rumors about me, about my business, about my family, about everything. So they feel that I'm could be a soft target, and they feel that, you know, political vendetta, political motivation is there always behind. So people feel that if you were in politics, you could fight your political war in parliament rather than fight from within your office or on the roads or whatever. But people feel that I should be there also because they feel that I can work much better and in a larger form. They feel that the amount of work I'm doing can come to credibility, much more credibility, if I was in parliament and being part of this family. It would be very difficult to do business as a businessman, and being a politician would be easy. I kept away from it, but many politicians have pulled me into this situation, and a lot of people in Amethi, Raebareli, and also different parts of India have put up posters for me to partake, and they would like me to be the candidate from their constituency, their area, because they feel that there'll be progress, there'll be a secular government, there'll be focus on unemployment, on women's safety, and for the farmers. So they know that I've learned a lot, I've seen a lot, I help a lot, so they feel that I should be there. But obviously, I don't do any such thing without the consent of my family. It's very important for me to get their approval and also their blessings on whatever step I take. And also from the Congress Party, if they feel that I should be part of this, only then I will be part of it. I know people will want me to always be part of politics, but I think I need the consent of Congress and my mother, my wife's family.